The regular way to play half guard is to, well, deep half guard please, to an overhook please, is to grab the leg and play from here. Now, what this technique does though is when Latif crosses the leg over, see, I'm gonna use my arm, which is usually behind the far leg, I'm gonna go behind the near leg. And you're gonna stick yourself to his hip and play from here. So one arm behind the leg. Get back, please. Yeah. So usually how do you get here? You play a regular half guard to try to go for the underhook, which is usually the best option. Go for the hip, go underneath. Now, whenever Latif starts to do the knee slide, or I can actually allow him to play the knee slide, he slides over, see? I can start using my arm, which was behind the far leg, put it inside and go behind the near leg. Now, the initial problem is this, look, if there is a lot of space here for Latif to go for the underhook. So he goes underneath, see? Then I'm in a worse position to go back, please, Latif. So when I'm here, I have to close that gap. So how do I close that gap? Is by putting my nose on the floor and dragging my top shoulder close to his hip. The more I flatten myself out, see, the more actually I can release the leg. I will show from different angle soon. So the more I get my bottom leg away, the more I'm gonna stick to his leg. So my goal is actually to come to my knees and stick to his hip. See my hip super tight, please, Latif? Okay, now, once I'm in this position here, there's a few things that Latif can do. Latif can keep his head high, and can keep it low, yes. And I can combine this, go back up please, with a windshield wiper on this side. Yeah, and go back, and windshield wiper on the other side. So these are the options that he has, and I have to take all these into account. Now let's go very easy initially. Put your nose on the floor, please, Latif, and keep your hip also low. Yeah. So over here. Well, it looks easy. It's like a regular turtle, but it's very hard to bring him out of balance. So what I usually do from here, I'm gonna post my nose on the floor. Same again, using the headstand that I'm always teaching. So put my nose on the floor. I'm gonna make a tripod. So we're gonna start to walk over Latif's back, and I balance myself here. It's like a trap a little bit. Initially, a common reaction for people here, they start to flip me over, please. When he pulls me back, I'm gonna dive my forearm over his hip, see? And just follow the motion and come on top. Let's do this again. So here, go with my arm behind his hip, see? My far hand can go to the hip or gets inside the leg as well. This is even better if I catch inside the hip. Go my arm behind the leg. Now from here again, Latif, make a turtle piece. So here, I'm gonna post my nose on the floor, see, tripod. I'm gonna walk around, see, and put myself on his back. And initially, I'm just gonna wait here. That's the thing, look, even if Latif doesn't do anything from here, if he just waits, see, I can pretty much stay here the whole match. And a common reaction here is for him to windshield wiper his leg, see, try to flip me over. And as he goes, I dive over the far hip and follow the motion. We rewind. Let's show from a different angle. So, arm behind the leg, nose in the floor, Latif makes a low turtle. I'm gonna go up, put my hip on his back, he starts to push me over. I roll, catch the hip, and come on top. So that's the first part of the rocking baby, of the rocking chair.